Behold, I send my messenger before thy face, who shall prepare the way before thee. The prophet holds the duty of communicating the coming of the Messiah. And for centuries leading up to the coming of our King and Lord, they've been doing just that. But among the prophets, there's none greater than St. John the Baptist. As Jesus said, among those born of woman, none is greater than John. Some may question what qualifies his greatness. While John the Baptist is certainly an exemplary model of his correspondence to the vocation, his greatness actually begins with the mission set apart for him by God himself, to be the sole prophet who personally knows and directly draws others to Christ. While St. John gets the fortune of being our team captain in this regard, Jesus concludes, yet he who is least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he. What does this mean? The saints who may not have had as great a vocation as John the Baptist, those who are perhaps like a doorkeeper for the inn, a farmer's field hand, or a lowly slave of King Herod, I don't know, these saints responded to the vocation with great zeal and service for God. These are the true hidden giants. The saints remind us that until we complete our pilgrimage in this world, we have to finish strong until we cross that finish line with that last step, that last breath. Even if no one remembers who we are or how we did it, then when we arrive at the shrine of all shrines, at the kingdom of heaven, the eternal gates, when we arrive at home, then God the Father will welcome us with arms outstretched and a grand smile. Then we may strive to fulfill these duties and responsibilities that God entrusts to us. And we do this with our particular vocations with great generosity, with the same zeal as St. John the Baptist, as our Blessed Virgin, as St. Joseph, her spouse, and all the saints. Mother Mary, singular vessel of devotion, pray for us.